everyone. Welcome back to Life Sizing for the 50 Plus. It's been 2 weeks since we've had a live video, and so I'm back to tell you, give you some updates and talk today about our subject today is the 3A's of aging. This is kind of a two-part, probably is a two-part, and that 3A's is attitude affects aging. And we know, we have talked about it, you've read about it, you've heard about it, that everything that occurs in our life, we have a choice of what attitude we're going to process about things that happen. So two incidences that reinforce this attitude principle affecting our aging is we were in Mackinac Island last week. It was a trip that we had planned. It was on my bucket list for a long time. Mackinac Island is northern Michigan, and there are no cars, no vehicles, none. There's an ambulance that I don't know, I asked if it was electric, but you really didn't hear it. But everything is horse-drawn, or it is bicycles, or walking. I think I saw a couple scooters maybe. But anyway, that's this beautiful premise that it's just all about nature. The flowers, some of you, I'm going to post some more this week now that I'm getting myself organized, getting back home. But we had a couple setbacks on this trip. One was on the way up, we had a flat tire. Bob had checked and the spare and all that business, but that was an ordeal for a lot of reasons, and I won't go into all those details, but the repair place said that it was a screw that we caught on the highway, all that business. We do have AAA, which I highly recommend. But anyway, so Bob wasn't really on his game when we left for a lot of different reasons, but the first few days when we were there, he experienced some health issues, and he was devastated because of our expectation and excitement for this trip, right? So just real briefly capsulize, many of you know, but many of you do not know, that in 2015, Bob was diagnosed with stage 4 metastasized lung cancer. And he had never smoked, he was an athlete, just the unexpected. So point to you all, if you have any skin cancer, the melanoma, praise God, literally, our doctor was like a Dr. Welby. And he suggested, Dr. Ray Fisher, he's retired, that, not suggested, he told Bob, melanoma likes or often comes back in the lung. Who knew? So Dr. Fisher recommended and strongly suggested Bob get a lung x-ray every year. When we tell people that, they're like, why? This is not necessary. Well, so he had had something, I wasn't even going to get into this, but now that I'm into it, I'll finish it. I believe it was like 58 years before, he had a skin cancer on his back that was removed by a dermatologist slash surgeon, and they said all the margins were clear, all good. Nevertheless, Bob had the lung x-ray every year that literally has saved his life, because it would have gone undetected. So we won't even go there for what ifs. So the reason I'm bringing this up, because he's been on treatment and doing really, really well since 2015. Sometimes things just are off a little bit. Unfortunately, it was during our big trip. So I'm telling you all this because I had a choice about my attitude. I could have gone to the pity party. I could have just done all kinds of not so positive reactions. But I made a choice from the very moment things started happening, even with the flat tire, that I was going to stay in control of my emotions and my attitude. And that's what I did. I am not bragging about that. I'm using it as an example. I've worked very hard over the years not to go to the other side. And of course, being a woman of faith, I rely solely always on the power of prayer to keep me stabilized, keep me in a place of protection, so that because when you've been married as long as we have, your spouse knows exactly if you're on or off. And that's the last thing Bob needed, was to have me like freaking out or, you know, anyway, you get it. So that's number one on the attitude of what happened last week. Then yesterday we were at friends for dinner, and they're quite a bit younger than us. A lot of people are. And she was saying that she was very disappointed that her grown son, he's 24-ish, changed his plans and is not coming to visit them. He's in the service overseas. He's going to his friends in Atlanta, or his girlfriend, I think, in Atlanta. Well, you know, if you've been waiting for an adult kid to come home and you have all these thoughts and plans, and then they're, oh, by the way, mom and dad, I'm not coming there. I'm going to see my girlfriend. So I had the opportunity to share a little bit about our attitudes as our life stages change. This was the perfect example. This is a new life stage for this beautiful couple. And there's none of us have been to the next life stage. None of us, unless you have a time capsule or something. But the key is to get prepared. I wasn't for the empty nest. I wasn't for, I call it the launching stage, you know, that 20s where they're choosing life, and it's tough. So fortunately, I did have a mentor or two, and that just saved me from being a total idiot. Not that I wasn't close, but that's one of the reasons I wrote my book, Design Smarts, because I talk about these life stages. The best thing we can do for ourselves is to get knowledge. You know, there's a verse, Hosea 4:6. It's in the Old Testament. The Old Testament. It says, my people perish for lack of knowledge. And we may not perish, but we can certainly have a tough time going through stages that we're not prepared for with the right attitude and with the right or the necessary preparation. My whole philosophy and goal for you all is preparation and knowledge. You want the preparation, but you want to prepare with the correct knowledge. And the best way to get knowledge I have found is for those that have been there, those that are wise, those that you respect. And I hope that you have people in your life that are like that. But if not, pray about it. Seek it. It takes a humbling, right, to go to somebody and say, I'm really struggling here. I need some help on this. Could we meet or could we talk or whatever? I just did that last week with a situation. Or the week before we left. So anyway, this is the post today. This is about the 3A's of aging. Attitudes definitely affect our aging. If you want my book, I send it out to you right away, signed copy. It's on my website, mitzibeach.com. It's a bargain for what knowledge for aging gracefully is in here. So as we close, we say our motto because it is critical to our life stages and moving forward. So it is, we do more for ourselves so that we can be more for others, especially those that are behind us in the life stages, and our family and our friends, okay? All right, you all, have a good week, and I will be with you again next Tuesday. Bye-bye.